Hey, Math Ones, how's it going? I'm doing great. We're gonna learn the equal values method. Well, actually, let me be more specific. We're gonna learn how to solve the systems of equations through substitution using the equal values method. Now, I know that seems like a lot, but it's basically finding the points of intersection by putting two equations equal to each other. Maybe that was confusing too, but that's what we're gonna do, okay? So we'll do it by graphing first. We'll do it by graphing, okay? Watch my videos on how to graph the system of equations. Now it's solving through substitution. I don't know, just watch if it'll make more sense. You need graph paper. Pencil. I'm using pen. Always do math and pencil. I'm doing pen so you can see the different colors. It's fancy. You become a better teacher that way. Woo! Good instructor. Ruler, 100 lines nice and straight. You want those lines straight. Gah! And I think that's it. You need your brain. Make sure you get a good night's sleep. Eat your vegetables. And you exercise. We're all gonna exercise. And take a shower. You wanna look good. I mean, not that looking bad. I mean, you look good for who you are, but when you feel clean, when you feel good, you work good. Be comfortable. Make it work in a nice, quiet place. Give your mom a hug. Give your dad a high five. Or give your dad a hug. Change your little sister's diapers. And then go for a jog. It's a beautiful day. We live in Oxnard. One of the most beautiful places in the world. I'm telling you this. I am telling you this. One of the most beautiful places in the world. Oxnard. If you don't think it, but go out and go see. Beautiful. All right, let's get to work. Here's where I'm gonna graph, I have it on my phone. Find out where those two lines intersect. That's what we're gonna do. Let's do it! Let's do it! Yeah! Okay, now. Here's what we're gonna do. First, I'm going to graph this. Let me explain. This is not the way I want you to solve this, but I want you to see how this all works. So we wanna find where these two intersect by not graphing, but by setting them equal to each other through substitution. Okay, but first, let me graph this so you can see what the answer is by graphing. And then after that, we won't do graphing and stuff like that. So anyway, the y-intercept, let's graph y equals negative 3x minus 11. The y-intercept is negative 11. So let's go negative 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, way down there. And then negative 3 is my slope. So I go down 1, 2, 3 over 1, but I don't have room that way. Let's go up this way. 1, 2, 3 over 1, up 1, 2, 3 over 1. Up 1, 2, 3 over 1. Up 1, 2, 3 over 1. 1, 2, 3 over 1. 1, 2, 3 over 1. And so forth. Okay, now let's just go ahead and plot those points. Let's make a nice little line. Now watch all my, if you don't know what I'm doing there, watch all my other videos on how to graph this line. Y equals negative 3x minus 11. And then let's graph this one. Y equals 4x plus 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 4x means I go up 1, 2, 3, 4 over 1, but I don't have room for that. Let's go this direction. Down 1, 2, 3, 4 over 1. 1, 2, 3, 4 over 1. 1, 2, 3, 4 over 1. Boom, there's our intersection right there. 1, 2, 3, 4 over 1. Okay, we have the point of intersection, but I'm gonna go ahead and graph it. Okay, so this is y equals 4x plus 10. Now, here's my solution right there. That's where they intersect. Let's write the answer down the way I want you to write it. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. So backwards, negative 3, down, negative 2. There's my answer, negative 3, negative 2. But that's not how I want you to solve this, okay? When I have this on the test, I'm going to say solve it through substitution. And so we're going to have to get this answer a different way. So you see that that's my answer, but let's see if we can do it a different way. This is the way I want you to do it. Y equals 4x plus 10, okay? And then the other one is y equals negative 3x minus 11. Where do these two intersect? Now we have to find out where they intersect without graphing using substitution. Now because these are both equal to y, there's a couple ways you can look at this. The actual proper way is to say, hey, this is equal to y. So wherever there's a y, I can go ahead and plug it in that. Now if that doesn't make sense to you, instead of writing y equals negative 3x plus 11, I could write 4x plus 10 equals negative 3x minus 11, right? Because they're both equal to y. Or you could say, hey, they're both equal to y, you could just set them equal to each other. Ultimately, it's going to look like this. 4x plus 10 equals negative 3x minus 11. Okay? Now, since this equals this, this will give me a solution. We have two x's. Let's get rid of one of the x's. Let's get rid of this x here. I have negative 3x, so I add 3x. Whatever I do on the left side, I can do on the right. I add 3x. And then go ahead and solve. What's 4x plus 3x? 7x. Bring our 10 down. That goes away, and we have negative 11. Okay, now I have to solve for x. So I take away 10. 7x equals, what's negative 11 plus negative 10? Negative 21. Divide by 7. X equals negative 3. Now, I also have to solve for the y. So I have the negative 3 as my x. Now you take your negative 3 and you plug it into one of the original equations, that equation right there. So instead of y equals 4x plus 10, instead of 4 times x plus 10, what did I say x is equal to? X is equal to negative 3. So we plug in negative 3. What's 4 times negative 3? Negative 12 plus 10. What is negative 12 plus 10? Well, they're both opposites, so you subtract. That is actually going to be negative 2. So guess what? My x is negative 3. My y is negative 2. My answer is negative 3, negative 2. Based on that, what was my point of intersection? What did I say my point of intersection was through graphing? The same exact answer. Okay, so that's how you find the point of intersection through substitution using the equal values method. Now, but wait, let's plug this negative 2 into the orange equation. I'm sorry, let's plug the negative 3 into the orange equation. So I plug it into the purple. Let's plug it into the orange. Y equals negative 3 times x minus 11. What if I get that? What would I get for my y? What would y equal? Well, let's plug in negative 3. Okay, y equals negative 3 times negative 3. 9 minus 11. What is 9 take away 11? Negative 2. So you get the same answer no matter which equation you plug it in. So there you go. That's how you do the equal values method. Let's try a couple more examples, and then we'll be done. Okay? Okay. So, now, let's use the equal values method to solve the system of equations for these two linear equations. Let's figure out where they intersect. So now they're both equal to y, so we can just go ahead and set them equal to each other. 2x minus 2 equals negative 4x minus 8. Okay, now to solve this, let's bring the x to one side. I have two x's, so let's bring the, I like the x's on the left. That's what I like. So I have negative 4x, so I'm going to add 4x. That becomes 0. What's 2x plus 4x? 6x. Bringing down the minus 2, that's 0, negative 8. Now, let's go ahead and solve for x. So I need to add 2 on both sides. Negative 8 plus 2 is negative 6. And I divide by 6 on both sides. Now there's my x. Now, how do we figure out the y? Well, you take the x and you plug it into the equation, the original equation. So let's go ahead and do that. Y equals 2 times, instead of x, what's my x equal to? Negative 1. And just solve for y. What's 2 times negative 1? Negative 2 minus 2. Negative 2 minus 2 is negative 4. Now, let's plug it in the purple equation to see if we get the same answer. Let's plug this x into the purple equation. Y equals negative 4 times x minus 8. What is x equal to? Negative 1. Okay, so let's go ahead and solve this one. What is negative 4 times negative 1? 4 minus 8. What does 4 take away 8? Negative 4. Notice, I get the same answer. That just helps me to know that my answer is correct, that my negative 1 is correct. So my final answer is this. X is negative 1, and Y is negative 4. That is my point of intersection. Let's do one more, but let's take a break first. So we did two equations. We did two problems by finding the point of intersection. We'll just do one more, then we'll be done. But we'll take a little break, or you can fast forward through my talk if you want to, as we're taking a little break. But I just had a quick question for you guys. I was want your opinion. The other day, I was shopping at Trader Joe's. I was wearing my mask, you know, because I didn't want to get people infected or anything like that. And I had the urge to sneeze. So there's my wife. That's Leanne over there. All right. She just got off from work. Crazy. I'm still working because I'm making videos. It's my job now. Making videos, teaching you guys math. Your job is to watch these videos. But anyway, so I had a sneeze. And I'm wearing this mask. Now I have two options here. One, I only have one mask, but I only have one mask in the store with me. One, I sneeze in the mask. Or two, I take off the mask and I sneeze in the store. Now, the question, Leanne's saying to sneeze in the mask, but I mean, honestly, I have to be honest. I know that's the right answer, is to sneeze in the mask, but is the only, what would you do? You sneeze in the, if I sneeze in the mask, all the snot and mucus is going to be in the mask that whole time that I go shopping in the store. Now, first of all, that's kind of gross. I mean, I'll do a lot of gross things, but sometimes I have my limits. But even if I didn't mind that, what do you think people are going to think if I just have a big old wet spot just hanging out, dripping from the mask? You know, what are people going to say? But then again, at the same time, if you sneeze out in the middle of the store, people are going to be all, oh my gosh, coronavirus, which I get. I'm not making fun of people about that because I get it. That's a bad thing too. So that's the dilemma. So you know what I did? I actually took off my mask and I sneezed right there in my cough catcher. I guess maybe that was the wrong decision. I don't know. Tell me what you would do.
I'm
write something in the comments if anyone's watching these videos. I don't even know if anyone's watching this right now. But anyway, that was my dilemma. Let's do one more problem, shall we? Okay, here's our last one. Go ahead and pause the video and try this one on your own. Okay, see what you can do. All right, now that you did, see if you get the same solution as me. 3x plus 10 equals negative 3 over 2x plus 1. Oh, we got a fraction here. That's okay. We're not afraid of fractions. So, okay. Let's go ahead and get rid of this by adding 3 over 2x. Okay, what is 3x plus 3 over 2x? Well, let's do a side thing over here. 3, let's just add 3 plus 3 over 2. Plus 3 over 2. Now, I have a denominator of 1 with my 3, but I want the denominator to be 2. So I multiply by 2. If I multiply by the denominator by 2, the numerator I have to multiply by 2, so I get 6 over 2. And this still remains 3 over 2. Now I can add these. What's 6 plus 3? If the denominator is the same, you just add the numerators. That is 9 over 2. And it's 9 over 2x plus 10 equals 1. Okay, now let's take away 10 on both sides. 9 over 2x equals, what is 1 take away 10? That is negative 9. Okay, now how do I get rid of 9 over 2? Well, let's multiply both sides by the reciprocal, 2 over 9. That will reduce it. So let's multiply, that's just how you get rid of a fraction. Multiply this side by 2 over 9. That goes away. X equals, okay, a couple ways we can do this. Multiply the numerator times the numerator is negative 18. The denominator times the denominator is 9. Negative 18 divided by 9 is negative 2. After all that, we got negative 2. Or you can reduce these. The 9's cancel out and ends up being negative 2. Anyway, got the negative 2. Now I have to plug the negative 2 into our original equation. Let's plug it into both of them. Y equals 3 times x plus 10. I'm doing this one even though it's in purple. I plug in the negative 2. What's 3 times negative 2? Negative 6 plus 10. What is negative 6 plus 10? Y equals 4. Okay, now let's plug our negative 2 into our other equation, 3 halves. Now it's another fraction, but it's good fractions every once in a while. Negative 3 over 2, x plus 1. What do I plug in for x? Let's plug in negative 2. Now again, can do negative 3 over 2 times negative 2 over 1. Okay, this becomes a fraction of 1. And you just say, hey, negative 3 times negative 2 is 6. 2 times 1 is 2. And we'll say that's 3. Okay, so negative 3 over 2 times negative 2 is 3. So we'll say y equals 3 plus 1, this becomes 3 plus 1 is 4, which we get the same answer. So we know our answer is correct. So the question is, what's the point of intersection? The point of intersection is x is negative 2 and y is 4. And there is your answer. Make sure you have an X and a Y for your solution. And that's it. Those are our problems, okay? So go ahead and make sure you know how to do those on your own. Make sure you practice those. It's the best way to get those. All right. So that fraction one was pretty challenging, but there are fractions in the real world. So you need to go ahead and just, you know, look it over again. If you want me to do another fraction, write it in the comments. I'll do another one for you guys to take a look at. But just make sure you remember your fraction rules. All right. So, I'm glad I had the discussion about the mask. Let me know what you think. And, I don't know, things are rocking and rolling. Another video on Thursday. I think the school year is going to end pretty soon here. Not to say on the record, but not on the record. I believe June 5th will be our last day of watching videos. What are you going to do? You can't watch any more math videos. Well, let's see. You can go on a hike. You can ride your bike. You can read a book. You can take a jog. Do some push-ups. Play soccer, you can play baseball, you can play duck, duck, goose. Don't say there's nothing to do. There's so much stuff to do out there. You can play tag, freeze tag. Freeze tag where you have to run under the people's legs. You can play jellyfish crab. You can play twister. We should do outdoor stuff. It's a beautiful day. Play cricket. Arm wrestle, thumb wrestle, rock, paper, scissors, make lemonade, make Mexican rice, learn how to cut hair. You can probably make a lot of money if you're not afraid to cut hair nowadays. Anyway, this is Sensei signing off. See you next year.